Hello and welcome guys to a new video on YouTube to my channel. First of all, I want to say that this video will be the maybe one of the only videos that will be in English language. First of all, because I'm a very bad English speaking person, and second, because that's only by a request, so I want to do this tutorial again in English. So, okay, let's get started with this. First of all, I want to show you what the WebSocket chat looks like, what its features are, and what you can expect from this code. So, I've got two clients now logged into this page. My Chrome browser on the left side and my Incognito Chrome browser on the right side. So, these two clients act different. So I send a message like hello to the chat room, and you can see the chat on the left side displays the client 592 with a message hello, and on the right side I get the same message, but on the right side it's dark, so it's black displayed, and on the left side it's a little bit grayed out, so you can see that this is your message. I type a message again to all. So I want to say hello to all in this chat room. And maybe the first client will answer it like, hi, 592. So you see this works. Actually, this IDs are randomly IDs get from the socket. I will show you later how this works, but you can put a login script or something in front of this and send there the ID or the username with it. Would be something better to do. But I've done it for reasons. So let's go with this shit. When I reload the Incognito chat, the messages are gone. And I can send as another user. So you see the ID changes. Okay, so let's get started with the code. First of all, in the command line, I started this WebSocket within the direction of my server. It's on the local server installed. And I started this with the PHP exe and started the PHP file that's in my server directory. I share with you guys the link to my Google Drive folder, so you can download the whole thing. I show it to you really quick. So the server is running. I can stop it really quick here and start it again. So it's running now. It's that file here. This file, sorry. I open that up for you so we can go through it later. Next, you will need a vendor folder with Composer installed. And in this vendor folder, I got some autoloads, and I used the library Ratchet for this. This folder will be in the download link also, so you don't have to do that for yourself. Then I have a JavaScript file, jQuery, so make life a little bit easier. I've got a class folder, there's a DB class file in here. You don't have to use it because this chat is actually not connected with database, but you can do with the class that I wrote in here. You don't have to use it, you can use your own if you want to, but I'll leave it there so you can download. Okay, yeah, that's the files you needed. Of course, an index.php file is also there, and I'll show you these files right now. Okay. First of all, I got the index file, which creates a session randomly. That's my user ID. right now. I connect the jQuery file, of course, do a little bit of styling, nothing really big. Got an output area, got a input field, and got my functions down here. There we got later. So next of all, the server itself, I set a time limit to 0 so the script can run and run and run, and it only breaks if an error occurs or something. Okay, then it uses the namespaces for Ratchet library. It uses a little bit of an interface and then the server and something you get from Ratchet. You can read that at the ratchet.io, I think, was the website. I maybe put it in the description too. So yeah, I put the autoload file in here, the class chat, which is this file, implements the message component interface. Yeah, I know the file isn't named right, but it's only for tests, so I think you guys can do it better. So I get two variables here called clients and users. The users variable is not used in this tutorial, but I put it here for purpose. I explain later why. So then I got an got a constructor which instantiated an SPL object storage at the clients variable. What that is, you can also read that at the homepage. It's just a storage like an database storage or something. So yeah, I got a little bit of functions here, like four pieces of them, and it's for open state, close state, message state, and error state. Error state is really easy to explain. It closes the connection, of course. The open state, the open function, open method, connects the client. It attaches the connection. You get a connection interface through this method and attach it to the clients. This one is also, that's the one I would like to explain. I get from the connection the resource ID, so this is the user ID which is generated by the WebSocket, and save it in the users array and save there the connection to so I can use it later on the on message function, but I don't use it in this tutorial, so it's not there for use. Yo, you know my English is not very good. So you don't have to use it. I comment it out. So also in the onClose function, there's the same thing. You detach the connection from the clients and you unset it. Yeah, you know. And in the onMessage function, you get two parameters. That's from, that's the from object from which the message is sent, and the data object, which also contains the data we send from the client. This is what I show you a little bit later. Now I save my ID from the client that sends the message. That's the resource ID in the from object. And the data object is JSON, so I decoded JSON and I get a type and switch this type through and send then the message out. I get here in detail later on. So now down here I start the server at whichever IP or domain you're running this server on. For me it's localhost and I run it at port 88. You can here determine which port you want to run the server on, And yeah, you're good to go and run the server. That's all you takes on the server side. And in the client, you have to do the following. You connect to the WebSocket with WS double point slash slash localhost double point port. When you want to do WSS for secure WebSocket, you have to install an SSL certificate and, of course, put it in the config files of your server. If you want to do that, I'll maybe do a video about that in the future, but not right now. Okay, so then we get an unopen method here also. We send in the unopen data to the server. We send there that we're logging in, and it's the type socket. I call that socket, and I put the user ID here, which was created above on the top of the file, on top in the file, whatever. So you know what I mean, I guess. So on error, there you can do a little bit of error handling. I don't do that at the moment. You can do so if you want to. On message is relatively easy. You parse the JSON, which you get from the event punct data, event.data, you know, yeah, and switch that. And in case of chat event, you put output that in the div chat output and append it there. I append there JSON.message. I called that variable message. And yeah, I show you why this is called in the server side later on. Now we get to the event handling from the input field. I do this on key up and I check for the enter key and shift key. So if you press enter and shift, you get a new line. And if you press enter, you send the message. At the moment, you press enter, the message is stored at chat message variable, and you send this variable to the server, to the WebSocket, with stringify JSON with type chat, the user ID, and the chat message. After that, it cleared the text area so you can start from scratch. Yeah, that's for the index. Now we get a little bit in detail on the onMessage method in the server. Here we switch the type of the data we get. And in case of chat, I put the user ID in the variable, the message in the variable, and I create the HTML for the response of the sender and this response of the receiver. So the client that receives the message got a little bit of an different looking HTML than the sender. Of course, you've seen that before with a little bit grayed out styled message. And then restart the output. The from user gets via send method a JSON array, a JSON data with which contains an array in PHP, and there is the type we get from the client. So the type is in this case chat, and the message is the response HTML message for from, of course. Then we loop through the clients that are logged into our sites, to our site, and we look for every client that is not us, of course. They don't want to get the message twice, and send it to the client, to each client, and send it via JSON encode and put the array of the type and the message in there. That's it on the server side. What I wanted to point out here is this one, the event.data object contains the type which I mentioned before. So this type is JSON.type, and switch it will be case chat, and JSON.message will be the message, so the HTML markup which was defined here. Yeah, that's the magic of the WebSocket server I got here. Anything else I want to point out? I think that's it for this tutorial, guys. I hope you understand what I wanted to show you. I know I'm not the best English speaker. I can only repeat myself. I'm sorry for that. But I guess you get what I wanted to say. So thanks for watching anyways, and please be sure to leave a comment if you liked what you see, and leave feedback as always. So stay tuned for next videos, and that was it for now. Peace out.